People, I congratulate you, congratulate the President Nana Akufo-Addo and the Great Elephant Party for winning the 2016 elections. You can call on us at any time. If it had not been so before, this time I think it will be. We wish to state here that we are solidly behind our son, Honorable Peter Johnny Amau, whose good works the President, His Excellency Nana Akufo-Addo, has seen and first appointed him and has finally given the nod to be the minister for the most serious ministerial position in Ghana at this time.
For who?
Which is the Galamse issue party.
For who?
I know the President knows that no other person can handle this ministry other than John Peter Amau. The Green State is solidly behind him and solidly behind the party, and we hope is going to execute this assignment for the whole world to know that we have a son in the person of John Peter Amau.
We are all here because the Green State is celebrating a true son and hero in the person of John Peter Amau. But I must say, as important as all the dignitaries here mentioned are, the most important person today who is here is actually not John Peter Abeu, but his mother, Mrs. Gertrude Abeu. She is the one for whose work and hard work we are all here today to celebrate. Without her, we will not have John Peter Abeu today. She labored and toiled, and we are saluting her today, and may God bless you, and may God make you live longer and longer and longer forevermore. We are most grateful. Of course, everybody knows about his intellectual capacity. This is an energy expert, and he gave us so many ideas in that area. The president, in his wisdom, and thankfully for all of us in Ghana, has appointed him to the position of Minister for Lands and Natural Resources. As everybody has said, this one is a very big ministry. All our gold is in his hands. All our diamonds in his hands. All our bauxite in his hands. All our forests, all our natural resources are in his hands. So we really, really thank God for this appointment, because we could not be in more capable hands. He's really, really an honor to the people of the state and the people of Ghana. We thank God for him. Of course, he's helping Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo and the government to pursue the agenda that Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo has laid down for the transformation of this country. The creation of this new economy that we are embarked on cannot be possible without the support of John Peter Abeu and the work he's doing and is going to do in the Ministry of Lands and Natural Resources. As a government, Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo wants you to know that he is engaged daily, nightly, in the business for which you elected him. It is very clear from the very first budget of this government, which was read on March 2nd, that Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo is a man of his word. He is a man of his word. He told the whole country, as we campaigned for the 2016 election, he said, "Give me the mandate and I will restore teacher training allowances." And he has been given the mandate, and in the very first budget, we have restored the allowances, and they will start paying in September this year. He said, "Give me the mandate, and I will restore nursing training allowances." And then he was given the mandate in the very first budget. He has restored the nursing training allowances to be paid in September this year. Nana Akufo-Addo also said, "Give me the mandate and I will bring free secondary school education to Ghana." The people of Ghana have given him the mandate. And in our very first budget, we have restored free senior secondary school education in Ghana to begin in September. He said, "Give me the mandate and I will make sure every constituency in this country every year will get the equivalent of $1 million a year." Nana Akufo-Addo has been given the mandate, and this year every constituency in Ghana will be getting the equivalent of $1 million for development in the constituency. He said, "Give me the mandate and I will establish the Zongo Development Fund for the people in the Zongo communities for the first time in the history of Ghana. He was given the mandate and he has established Zongo Development Fund with a seed money of 290 million Ghana cedis for the Zongos in this country. This is a man of his word. He said, give me the mandate and we will bring one district, one factory. He has been given the mandate and you will see by June we will be rolling out one district, one factory in Ghana. We want to create jobs. We want to transform the economy. And so we are all going to be putting our shoulders to the wheel. The key part of the job creation is creating a vibrant private sector, making sure our city is stable. When we came, it was running 100 meters speed. We have arrested that a little, and we will continue to work to keep the city stable. We are bringing inflation down, and by the grace of God, inshallah, we will also bring interest rates down significantly. So the work that John Peter Amewu is doing with Nana Akufo-Addo and the government is the work that you voted for Nana to do. So we ask the people of the B State and the people of Ghana as a whole to continue praying for Nana Akufo-Addo and the government, because we are going to do, inshallah, great things for this country. We are going to do some great things for this country. This is not a government that is going to be tainted with corruption. He says he is bringing a special prosecutor for corruption, and the bill is in the works, and you will see the special prosecutor, he or she is going to be very busy this year. So John Peter Amewu is a gem. He's a gem of the D State. He's a gem of the Volta region. He's a gem of Ghana as a whole. We salute him. We thank him. God bless him. God bless his sweet mother. And God bless the people of Ghana. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum.